Today on Louisiana Outdoor Adventures TV, we're in Shell Beach, Louisiana in St. Bernard Parish, and we're fishing with Captain Jimmy Corley, Jr. of Waterfowl Specialist Guide Service and Kerri, St. Bernard Parish Councilperson at Large. We are going to the Long Rocks, and every springtime, this is a place that is a hot fishing spot. The speckled trout start moving from the interior marshes to the outside, and when they get on the Long Rocks, they bite and bite well. It's a popular spot. You can catch lots of fish, and we're going to show you how to do it today on Louisiana Outdoor Adventures TV.
Closed captioning is brought to you by Busby Modular Tackle Storage. Customizable internal bins allow you to personalize your tackle box, featuring a waterproof and airtight gasket which makes it float. Secured with stainless steel hinges and latches, industrial strength materials ensure this box is built to last. Get yours today at busby.com.
Well, anytime you go fishing, it's always good to get a good night's sleep the night before, and that's exactly what we did at Captain Jimmy Corley's Lodge. It is a great place, clean, comfortable, AC blows cool, and we got a great night's sleep, then headed over to the boat, armed with Campo's live shrimp, and then made the run to the Long Rocks. Long Rocks are about a 35-minute run from Campo's Marina, so it's not right around the corner, but it's certainly worth the boat ride to get down there. And once you do, there's going to be a lot of boats when the fish are biting, and that's what's the case here today. A bunch of boats out on a weekday morning, but we find us a place in the rocks, get tucked in, and start catching fish.
There he is. Right up on our rocks.
Got one?
Yeah. Trout.
All right, Jimmy's got one.
Beautiful trout.
On top of the rocks. Nice fish, buddy.
Yes, sir. Campo's live shrimp. Well, right now, the bait just started showing up this week here. So we fishing close to the trout are running the edge of the rocks right now, chasing the bait. And that's what we're producing right now.
When you're fishing the Long Rocks, not only are there a lot of boats, so you have to watch out for the crowds, but it can get a little crowded in the boat as well because you're fishing in a limited area. You're casting towards the rocks. So once Jimmy caught his first fish on a live shrimp and we knew they were there, I kind of got in the back of the boat and decided to throw some artificial baits. So Kerri and Jimmy sat in the front. They were catching them on live shrimp, and I did really well in the back of the boat using a variety of artificial lures. That's a good trout on a Meridine. That's what I like. Coming out here, throwing on these rocks. There we go. That's a pretty Meridine trout right there. And when you get these fish on top of these rocks like this, it's real good to throw on top of them. Because it's a slow sinking bait and it's not gonna get into the rocks, but you can catch some good fish.
Got a fish, Jimmy.
Gary's got one.
I was just holding the line.
Nice trout, Kerri. Nice.
Fish on. Beautiful trout.
Pretty fish coming in the boat. Jimmy's got one. Kerri's got, well, Kerri had one. But Jimmy's catching a good one there. Jimmy, why are these fish here right now? They just this time of year?
Just time of the year. We got the full moon last night. A lot of the bait showed up. Like I said, this week the bait just started showing up in here pretty good. And they just doing their pattern.
Yeah, there's one right there. That's a better fish. That's a much better fish. Much better fish. Boy, they are hitting this plastic right now like crazy. Look at that one. And all we're doing is casting and retrieving. I've got a 3/8 ounce death grip jig head on here and a women head matrix shad. And I'm just chunking and winding because these fish right now have moved off the rocks. I'm kind of watching what they're doing with the corks up there, and they've moved off the rocks a little bit. And when fish aren't overly aggressive and you're not getting the bites on corks, cast and retrieve. That bait's moving a lot faster, and you're gonna put that fish and put that bait in front of a fish a lot quicker. So that's what I'm doing right now, and I'm gonna see if I can continue to pick up a few more. Another one.
Yep.
All right. So they're gonna go with the live bait, and they're gonna go with a longer leader here in a minute. Because what we're finding now is these fish are a little bit deeper. And as soon as we get Kerri in the front of the boat with that longer leader, we're gonna see a difference. But trout are biting on the rocks.
Fish on.
There you go, buddy.
Big deep. All right, Jim, here it comes, my babe. Coming to you, coming to you. Got a hot one. Right there, fellas, that's where it's producing. We had to switch gears, go deeper. As you can see, we're about 4 feet under the cork right now. Putting them together.
That's a good fish there. Golly, right on the side of the boat he hit it. Look at that. Get him in there. Oh, before he gets off, don't jump out. Don't jump out. So this is what St. Bernard Parish is all about. You get out here in the summertime, in spring, and you're gonna catch speckled trout. We've got great captains like Jimmy that's gonna take you out here, and you're gonna catch these fish. Gotta come, gotta catch it, gotta experience it. Kerri, you got one. Kerri's got a good one. Kerri's got one on the rocks. Kevin's got one off the rocks.
Jimmy's still waiting.
Kerri's got a beautiful nice trout.
There you go.
There's trout number one, and as Jim turns around, here's trout number two.
Oh, here we go, double.
And a triple. That's no double, that's a triple.
Triple.
Jimmy's got one.
Yeah, but I don't
know.
Look at that. Yeah, look at Kerri's trout.
This is what it's about, Kevin.
It is.
Now is the time to come to St. Bernard.
It is the time to come.
We're opening up, everything's getting going. Festivals are starting back down here, and we're getting into fishing season.
And I'm gonna tell you something. Listen, we're gonna bring all of our fish up here, and just because Jimmy's is the smallest, we're gonna show them all off. But one of the things we can tell you is that when we come down here, you know, Kerri, we talk about our fishing, talk about the food, festivals and everything. But the other thing that we have, like Jimmy's place, is some great lodges where you can bring your family, you can stay at the lodge, walk across the street, get on the boat. It doesn't get any easier.
Absolutely, they're getting some more and more lodges like that down here. It makes it so convenient. You know, you don't have to drive in from wherever you're staying. If you're coming in from out of town, you can stay right here on the water. You know, wake up to a beautiful sunset and come, you know, 15, 20 minutes and catch some beautiful fish.
Here's one. Come on. fish. Nice trout here. I mean, these are good fish. A lot of times, when you're in fishing plastic around live shrimp, you're gonna catch smaller fish. The smaller ones are gonna hit, but these things are pretty aggressive. There's another one right there, right from the back of the boat. See, they put me in the back of the boat today. They're up there having a great time catching fish, but no, old Kev's relegated to the back. They're not even saying a word about it. Letting me have my pity party on my own. Paying no attention to any of this. Look at them up there. You're on the, you're stuck, Kerri, I think.
Nope, I got a fish.
Got a fish?
Mm-hmm.
Ooh, you got a
feels
sheephead.
Feels like a good, I was gonna say.
No, is that a trout or a sheephead?
Redfish.
Redfish. A little bit of everything out here.
That might make the cut.
A little slot red.
Welcome back to Louisiana Outdoor Adventures TV as we're having a great morning out here with Captain Jimmy Corley and Kerri Callais. A couple of things I want to tell you about fishing this particular area. You're fishing rocks, you're fishing structure. So when you come out here, make sure you bring plenty of live bait. Make it about 100 shrimp per person. The reason why, you're seeing us catching trout, but we've also caught quite a few sheep's head today. There are redfish out here as well, and the warmer it gets, hardhead catfish. So lots of bait stealers. If you're coming out and you're going to fish soft plastics, there's a lot of structure, not only right against the rocks, but when you come off the rocks, and you're going to lose a lot of jig heads. So whether it's live bait or soft plastics, bring plenty of shrimp and plenty of jig heads, and you're going to have success on the long rocks. There he is, on top of the rocks. Look at this trout. I love doing this. I love catching these fish on top of these rocks. I love catching these big trout on top of these rocks. How about that? That is nice. Right on top of the rocks. It's so fun getting out here, throwing different baits. You know, live shrimp under a cork from Campos is the ticket. That's the easiest way to catch them, but I like throwing some different things, and right now, the different things are working. Did I call that or what?
Just needed your little bit of your luck, Kevin.
I called that, didn't I? Do I get credit for that fish,
Kerri? You get credit. This is totally because of you.
I said Kerri was about to catch a fish.
Yep, big old hollow head.
Woo!
I'm gonna lose.
Kerri is doing whatever she can to be conservationist today.
I am.
Between her and she's trying to throw the fish out the boat. There he is. Oh!
He came and jumped right in.
That's it. I'm gonna knock you right out of your spot.
I came right. I had to come up front and visit my friends
that's
up here. I had to come
up.
Visit y'all. I was lonely.
Jumped right in my spot.
I was in the back of the boat with Jim, and Jim's like, look, you're kind of cramping my style back here. Could you go up with them? So I had to.
I catch a fish, he throws right in the same spot while I'm getting the fresh bait. That's how it works.
You'd have done the same thing.
Absolutely.
You'd have done the same thing. Pick it up off the bottom. You did pick it up off the bottom. Look at that one. Well, it's not very often that you can come out here and do this.
Look at that fish.
But I'll take it.
What he means by that, Jim, is it's not very often that Kevin comes out here and catches the most fish.
Oh!
So you're saying he's got a good charter captain then, huh?
That was a shot right there from the front of the boat. That was a shot in front of the boat. Unfortunately, there's three cameras that are going to get that comment, too.
Oh,
there you go. That's a good fish.
Good trout right here. Good trout.
A good trout.
So
what we're finding today is just a kind of a strange bite. These fish are kind of hanging out in one area over here. And Jimmy, it's amazing that the plastic is doing as well as it's doing today. I mean, you really just wouldn't expect it.
No. If somebody would have bet the house on, I would bet the house. There ain't no way in the world. But Kevin, you're putting it on me today. I have to say that.
Yeah, and it's not about putting it on you. It's just, you know what I think it is I think that these fish are, I think these fish are scattered, okay?
They definitely are, yeah.
So when fish are scattered and you're fishing under a popping cork, you're stationary. When I'm casting and retrieving this bait, I think I'm covering a lot more water.
Yeah, you're covering more ground.
So I think that's more to it than anything right now. I think if these fish were just, you know, one of the boats has been catching a lot of fish in one spot, but I think the big key today is the fact that these fish are so scattered and just running that bait in front of their mouth and getting that reaction strike is what I'm doing right now. So we'll see if it continues to happen. LOA TV is brought to you by the Chandelier Islander Fishing Lodge. Full service, all-inclusive meals and lodging in the heart of the Chandelier Islands. Come stay and play in paradise. How the Pros Do It is brought to you by the Louisiana Charter Boat Association. Visit lasaltwater.com. It's been one of those days where I've had a lot of success fishing soft plastics today, and I've been using either an 1/8 ounce, which has been later because it's lighter and I lost a lot of the 3/8, or the 3/8 ounce Death Grip Jig Head. But the two colors I've been using today our matrix shad. I've been using two baits. The first one is the lemon drop bait right here. This is the matrix shad. This is purple haze and this is a vortex shad. There's just a difference in the way the tail is and the vortex that has a little bit more action to it. But both of these baits have been equally successful. And as far as the soft plastics today, they have done a great job. And those are the two colors that have done the trick for us out here in Shell Beach with Captain Jimmy Corley.
Oh, there he is. Good trout, good trout.
Good one. Looks like Jimmy's found him in front of us. Kerri, I think you need to cast up there.
Yeah, you might want to. There's a beautiful trout right here, fellas. St. Bernard's finest right there.
Well, that's a gorgeous fish. Doesn't get any better than what we're doing right now, catching all these fish here. And the fishing has just started. I mean, this is where it begins. And there's nothing better than coming down. Oh my goodness, that was a porpoise, a dolphin. That scared me to death, by the way. It got me off my point. I was trying to make a good point. Forgot what it was. Jimmy, was I making a good point?
Yeah, you was making a good point.
There's no better time than come fishing in Bernard.
Yeah, right, you can see the dolphins too. That's it, free dolphin tours. That's oh, I missed one. Free dolphin tours. There we go, that's a good fish. That's a good one. All right, I'm not casting where y'all been catching the fish. I'm not casting where y'all been catching them. Look at the size of this trout. Look at this. Golly. Jimmy, you are putting us on some fish today, brother.
So, here we go, here's another one.
There's another one. Kerri, you got one too?
Oh yeah.
Kerri missed one.
Another eater, babe.
Yeah, but this is so much fun.
Especially like we were saying earlier with all the lodges down here now, mm-hmm. It's a great place to bring the family or a girls trip, you know, come down here, get one of our captains to take you out. You know, a lot of times you can fish off of one of our piers down here, you know, can come and fish right off the dock.
You know what's pretty bad is we're making you talk right now. and not while we catch fish. That's pretty bad. So what, you ought to just tell me to shut up and you can go get a live shrimp.
Well, what a morning fishing out of Shell Beach, Louisiana today we had with Captain Jimmy Corley. And folks, this is just a preview of what summertime fishing in St. Bernard is all about. You're going to catch plenty of speckled trout. You can also go fish reds too. We've got a lot of fish down here. And I want to thank Captain Jimmy Corley with Waterfowl Specialist Guide Service for taking us out today and putting Kerri and me on these fish. We had an absolute blast. Come down here and enjoy St. Bernard Parish. We've got great food, great fishing, great culture, lots of things to do, very close to the city of New Orleans, and it is a place that you need to come visit and fish in this summertime. For Captain Jimmy Corley and Kerri Callais and producer Jim Caesar, I'm Kevin Ford. Thanks so much for watching, and we'll see you next week right here for Louisiana Outdoor Adventures TV.